Hello guys, now today I would like to show you how to create a registration, login and logout system in PHP. Now first of all we will begin by looking at the registration functionality. Now already in VS Code here I have pages here. I have homepage, index.php, register.php, sign.php, and connection.php. Now, first of all, let's look at the registration.php. Now, down here, we are having a registration form. That is the form you've this form here. This is where the form data is getting created. Now, if you look at this, this form is submitting data to the same page, which is register.php with post method. We're having three fields, the username field, the email field, and the password field. Now, these fields are validated. You can see if we enter even one of the names in the database is Obama. When we click, you can see the validation is working here. This is giving feedback to the user that the email field is required, password field is required, and email entered is invalid. Now, for the case of invalid email, now if you have for Obama, for example, the email is this, obama@gmail.com. Now suppose we remove the at another point and resubmit this, you can see we are having password field, should not be left blank, and you can see we have also invalid email. So every error is detected here and the feedback given to the user immediately. So, and once all this occurs, you can see we are redirecting back the user back to the form with these error messages here. Now, let's see, suppose all these details are available and this is a correct this one is a correct email now, but the password is wrong. Copy and paste here. Now the password is wrong, and I try to submit this. You can see the message, email or username already taken. So it means this user is already a registered user. So the username and email exist in the database. Now, for us to see how this works, I'll take you direct to register.php, where the form submits the data on top here. This is where data submitted to the form is manipulated. Now we are starting session using the function session start and declaring errors as a blank array, and we initialize all the variables be blank, require connection.php, which is here. Then this is our connection to the database. as you can see here. So when we move here, we check if the serve request method is paused, and then we do the field validation where we check if the username, if post username is blank, we use the function array push to add the error message to our blank array here. Else we assign the username to post username. Now if post email is empty, we do the same thing. We use the function array push to push the empty, email field should not be left blank, message to the empty array, and becomes part of the array. As you can see here, we do the same for all the fields. And once this is done, we also check for the email if it is a valid email. If it is an invalid email, we use the same function array push to add this error to the empty array. And if all this succeeds, then we check if the user already exists in the database by use of this query, select all from users where email is equal to one or password is equal to limit one, and then prepare, use prepared statement here, connection prepare email and statement bind params. SS, these are for string, this variable email and username are string, and then we bind the parameters with the function bind param, and then we use statement execute to execute the query, and then to get the result from that query we use result dollar result equals dollar statement get result function, and then to get all the users as an array we use result fetch assert. Now if the email that is submitted from the form is equivalent to user's email, the user's email in the database, or the username is the same as the user's username in the database, then it is automatically an error because the user already exists in the database. So we use the function again array push to add this error to our empty array. Now if you have completely zero error, there is no error at all, then password will be hashed using the function password hash, password submitted, password default, and then we use MySQL, or structured query language, and then we assign that to a variable, insert into users, username, email, password, values, and this we are using prepared statement again. Statement equals connection prepare statement bind param. Now there are three parameters this time around of all type string. The data type is string there, and then we write those and we use statement execute to execute all that. And then we set the session message to be record inserted successfully. Session username is users username, and session email is users email. There. Now once this is successful, we redirect the user to the register.php page. Now let's get try this. As you can see here, it worked. Let's try registering one member, like Dalton at Gmail. And then copy this and paste down here. Registered, and when we check the database here, we can check our database down just at the very bottom. You can see that a user by the name user Dalton has been added, and the email is here, and also the password is hashed, as can be seen there. Now, this is how to go about the registration process. Now, to display the errors there, we will come here and we check if count errors is greater than 0, then we use for if loop. For each error is error, then we echo error. And then we end for each loop there, and then also we end if at that point. Now we are echoing the value of those steps so as to prevent the user from returning the names, the values for the field each time there is an incorrect value in the field. Let me try for you this. Let's say you had a OGM, and then maybe other field, maybe the email you are having is OGM. Submit this, you can see there is the email is invalid, but the data is still in the form. This data are held here in the form because you can see we are echoing, we echo the username back here, and we also echo the email back at this point, and even the password is not, it does not go away, it stays even though there is the subfield are invalid. So this is very, very important, preventing the user from retyping even the correct field. So that is all to do with registration. We have seen it, that it is able to add data to the database, and that is the main thing. We are able to detect if the user is already a registered user. We are also able to check if the password matches with the password that is stored in the database, and we are checking also if the email that is entered by the user is a genuine email. So Now, let us now check the sign-in page, how the user signs in logs into the system. Now, I click on login here, there's a login form here. The same things are here. Now, let's say we want to log in. And maybe Rango is there, and then let's see, we remove Gmail, and then the password becomes this. the domain. We are not able to log in because all these details are wrong. So when we enter, maybe you are alone, then click login. It's a email field is required, password field is missing, you have entered an invalid email address. Now when we add a correct email address, try logging in again. We are not able to log in. Everything is correct, the password is also entered, and we try logging in. Now we are redirected to the home.php with a message here, welcome, Rango, you are logged in. And we are also able to sign out at that point. So let's see how the login works here in the index.php. Now, almost the same as register, we will use session start, errors, sign errors on empty, array like that. And then the username, email, and password fields are initialized as blank, and when the server request method is post, and if the username is empty and the error at index error name is name missing, we just do the same way we did in register.php. The only difference here is that we are checking. Okay, the validation of email here, we use filter var email, filter validate email, where this email variable here is the one that is from the email field in the form. So this is going to check if the email that is entered is a valid email. If not, if this is not, like we can see this exclamation mark is for testing. We are testing if this is not a valid email, then we are displaying this error. And if this is not the case, then we come up with a select query to select all from users where username, and here I'm using the prepared statement and binding parameters like that. The same way, get result, the users is result. Now we are verifying the password. Now we are not busy with whether the email already, of course the email already exists, but we want to check if the password that is entered by the user is the same password that is stored in the database, and we use the function password verify. So first of all, we check if it is not password verify, password that submitted, it's comparing the two, the password submitted and password in the database. And if this is not verified, then we will display this message, wrong password. And we redirect to index.php. Else, if this is successful, then session username equals user's username. And session email is the same as username. User's email in the database, and we redirect to home.php, and the user shall have been logged in. Now, at home.php, we check if the two sessions are set, that is the session username and session email. And we can check this if we did not start our session. So we must use the function session start to start the function, and then check if they are set. If they are not set, we'll direct the user to index.php and exit. Else, we welcome the user with the username and with the information that the user, telling the user that the user is logged in, and an option here, a link where the user can sign out at this point. Now, that is all about the registration, login, and logout system. Now, if you are new to this channel, then I would like to urge you to subscribe to my channel, and you will get more of these videos on PHP, giving you good tips on how to carry out some functionalities of a common website. Now, have a nice time. Let's meet in our next tutorial.